Becca!
It's time for Good Looking Kickstarters. I'm so excited.
So am I. This is going to be awesome.
It's a big, juicy week for games.
It is. It's a really good week to take a look at a bunch of good looking Kickstarters here on Good Time Society.
Logo. What you got for me first?
First game I want to look at today is Hippocrates, not to be confused with Hippocrates. Hippocrates is a Euro game about the origin of medicine. We're going way old school here, folks. We're going all the way back to Hippocrates. This game's by Alain Orban, who is the designer of Trois and Black Angel, some very thinky, crunchy Euros, and also art by Laura Bevon. You are playing as a successor to Hippocrates, and you're leading your team of doctors with the goal of perpetuating the treatment of your patients. And this game features a bunch of stuff. So it features auction bidding, tile placement, resource management, and lots more. There's a lot going on here.
I gotta say, I love this particular type of tile placement because you're kind of snapping them in this weird, like DNA. I don't know. It looks medicine-y, whatever it is.
It's totally medicine-y, right? It's not your typical, hey, just lay a bunch of tiles in front of you in like a row or a column or whatever. It's doing the DNA strandy thing. You are going to be playing four rounds of five phases each. You select patients for the hospital. You pay the doctors. You purchase medicine kits. You treat patients. This game is for 1 to 4 players. It does have a solo mode, and it's going to take about 90 to 120 minutes. So you are going to be, you know, sitting there doing the strategizing in your brain, and hopefully you're going to become the great successor to Hippocrates. I do have to mention, this is such a beautiful production. The tiles, all the little tokens, and you can actually upgrade to metal coins. And I love metal coins, especially the ones in this game. And it also includes a custom insert from Meeple Maker.
Oh, heck yeah. Game Brewer doesn't disappoint. I mean, honestly, it would be ridiculous if we didn't endorse this game, as did Man vs. Meeple and Rotto and Pardue Expert Game gave it an award. So, not surprising,
yeah.
But you're definitely going to want to pick it up.
What about you, Becca? What's on your list this week?
Okay, so this is Seven Moons, Heroes of Dragonreach. It's a smaller Kickstarter from a smaller game company. This is their second Kickstarter, Gunpowder Games. I think this game looks really intriguing. It's kind of taking components that make you feel like it's an open world game, but you are in the kingdom, you are recruiting allies, you have some really sweet dragon-shaped meeples, and you can do a whole bunch of stuff throughout the Seven Moons until you get to the point where all of you have to battle the Shadow Army. And so it's like that mix of cooperative and competitive where you are trying to get best positions to fight a bunch of monsters at the end in this big final showdown. So I think it's a really interesting novel game. It's not like everything you've seen, although thematically it is, of course, just, you know, trolls, orcs, pillaging, gaining cool resources and weapons and preparing for battle. But I like that there is this final epic conclusion to it that feels really important. And the win condition is to be left standing. And secondary condition is having highest victory points if more than one person happens to survive the Shadow Army.
Nice. Now, it's always interesting to me when a game has two options. You can either do cooperative or competitive. Becca, I know you. I'm going to guess you're going to prefer the competitive version of this game. Is that correct?
Oh, yeah. Well, technically, I may have been misleading. So it's not... It is competitive, and yet there are cooperative enemies to defeat.
Gotcha.
In the final battle.
So it's got that semi-cooperative feel to it. That's really cool.
Yeah, it also has this dice allocation element in the market. So it's a lot of different mechanics built into the game, depending on which different areas you want to be involved in all of the rounds leading up to the Seventh Moon. Honestly, I just want to put these dragon-shaped meeples in every other game. They're the only meeples you'll ever need.
We need more dragon meeples. That's all there is to it.
They have already unlocked their stretch goal to have a version in Tabletopia, so you can check it out there.
Nice.
But yeah, you're recruiting allies, building strongholds, preparing to defend the kingdom against the Shadow Army.
I like that, how, you know, you're all ramping up, you know, your crew here, and you're eventually going to fight, you know, the big baddie at the end, but only one of you is actually going to win, you know, but you're still helping each other out.
Yeah, it's like, hey, we're all in it together until we're not.
Okay, a game that I'm really excited about this time is Canvas Reflections. This is an expansion and a reprint. This is a game by designers Jeff Chin and Andrew Nerger with art by Luan Huyen. It's for 1 to 5 players. It's about 30 minutes long. And what I love about this, you are a painter in an art competition. You're collecting cards and you're layering them on top of each other. So if you ever played Mystic Veil, it's got this similar element where you have these transparent cards and you're layering them on top of each other.
Ah, the John D. Clare.
Yes, our buddy John D. Clare. It's very similar in that aspect where you're layering the cards, card crafting style. You're creating a unique painting. And these paintings, you know, they have the artwork, they have the icons, and you're going to reveal or hide icons depending on how you place the cards.
That's awesome.
And then these score differently every game. Yeah, it's so cool. They have so many different scoring options.
There's a lot of art-related games or art-themed games, but this one, you're actually basically making kind of a collage of the components already in there, which is really neat. You are actually making a unique piece of art, even though someone playing the game before could have made the same thing. But I like that element of it. It more accurately makes you the artist than other art-themed games.
Yeah, totally. Like, I love that of, you know, that I'm creating something, right? That I can, you know, hey, look at this little art piece that I did.
Honestly, I take a picture every time I play a game, but I think anybody is going to take a picture of their board after they play this game.
Oh, yeah, totally. This is just absolutely beautiful. So it's card drafting, hand management, set collection, but done in such a neat and different way. This one, I can't wait to back it.
It's time to get science-y with Genius Games. It's cellulose! Bam, 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 bam. We're in a cell. We're absorbing CO2 and water and spending our water to utilize our CO2. Or something like that. If I had the game, I would know the specifics, because what Genius Games does that is so cool is they're not making up a bunch of terms. They are taking science and taking history and putting it into a game. This one is about plant cell reproduction. It's so wonderful.
It's so sciencey.
They partnered with Tree Sisters, and for everyone that backs in the first 3 days of the campaign, they're going to plant a tree. So cool.
Oh, that's awesome.
Yeah, it's worker placement, but it's worker placement where you are competing for very scarce resources. You can either produce water, or you can use the water to absorb CO2 and help build the cell wall. It gets very sciencey, and if you want to know all the science behind it, it also comes with a booklet called Science Behind Cellulose that explains plant cell behavior. I just love what Genius Games is doing with all of their games, which is teaching people things, taking all of those words that you vaguely remember from 7th grade biology and actually giving them practical meaning for an adult or for children, and oh, it just makes your brain tingle.
I think they did another game called Cytosis as well. Again, they have these really cool themed, you know, games that are based on actual science. So this is, I'm looking at this like, you know, I think when we have more people gathered in schools again in person, they can use games as a way to learn. And I love that.
Yeah, exactly. Cytosis is the sister game to this game, Cellulose. And they go together, but they're completely standalone. Absolutely. I'm going to tell Mrs. Toole, if she is still teaching at my middle school, she should use this game. Every Friday, you get to play Cellulose and learn a little bit more about biology.
Shout out to Mrs. Toole. Yes, listen to Becca.
It's currently on Tabletop Simulator. If you're that kind of gamer that needs to try before you buy, you can check it out.
What else? We've got Rivet Heads. This is a game designed by Tony Miller, who did Fire in the Library, and Daniel Newman did the art, and he also designed some really cool games called Dead Man's Cabal and Rolled West. This one, you're in this like cyberpunk world. You're swapping swapping out your augments in your cyberpunk crew to be the best squad in the streets. For 2 to 4 players, about 30 to 45 minutes. This one's really neat. It's a programming game, which I don't have too many on my shelves, so I'm really interested in this one. You're playing cards, you're drafting cards, and programming your little assembly line of robots and battle bots to get out there to get yourself some victory points, or in this case, I think it's called rep points, your reputation. You're gonna play 3 cycles. Your assembly line moves along here as you draft cards, and eventually you're gonna see who has the best rep out there on the streets.
Oh boy, I need more practice on my programming games. Never have I played a programming game where it didn't go completely awry. I missed some part of my programming where it just goes completely off track.
Yeah, this one looks like a fun way to get to learn the mechanic a little better.
Yeah, only one way to get better at it. Be a rivet head.
All right, Becca, you've got another game.
I'm on an educational kick today, and I need to tell you about vowel. Okay, I think it's pronounced vowel, but you don't need the vowel in the word vowel. This is a spelling game. I really want to play vowel. It is a game where your turns are usually timed. You're trying to solve all of your cards, which are just a series of consonants that have a lot of word options that you could get right. Like severe would be S-V-R, but it could also be sever. Or it could also be, I don't know.
Several. There's several options.
Well, you need an L for that one because all the consonants are there. You just fill in the vowels.
Vowels.
You roll a die on your turn to decide which game mode you're going to play that turn. Either you're just going to need to race the clock and get through a bunch of cards, or you're going to be have a partner. If you're playing in at least a 3-player game, have a partner added to your team that's going to help you get through it, but you have more words to get through. Or it's going to be just a head-to-head race. But whoever wins a round, then they have a choice. The player can either take 2 victory points, or on the scoring track, they have this really interesting new mechanic where you can take 1 victory point and then move your victory marker, basically the location to which you need to get to win, which is independent for each player. That could be moved backwards 1 space, but you have to move it for an opponent as well. So basically, you're just shortening the distance you need to go, but doing the same for somebody else. It's a very interesting mechanic, and I'm excited to see how this can apply to different games and kind of be an inspiration to a new mechanic in the industry.
I like that, just shortening the game, but it's not just for you, it's for everyone. So you gotta sort of like pick and choose and be careful how you do it.
Yeah, this is from Cameron Art, who created Board Game Bulletin, which is just a board game update, a website that's really awesome. And Board Game Bulletin Publishing has been doing some great things. So congrats to them on moving into the publishing world with yet another game. Hey, what's a thing that you've always wanted, but you didn't know that you wanted?
Oh, I'm glad you asked, Becca. The thing I've wanted that I didn't know I wanted are little trains upgrades for my train games.
I mean, I see this and I just see Ticket to Ride, but I'm sure you know a million others that would be applicable.
I love train games like Ticket to Ride, Irish Gauge, Mini Rails, Paris Connection, all kinds of great stuff. The Little Plastic Train Company, which is by far the cutest name for a company I've ever heard. They are out now with a Kickstarter for their deluxe board game train sets. These things look absolutely amazing. They're just beautiful. They're replacement trains and scoring tokens for all those games we just mentioned, from Ticket to Ride to Age of Steam. They're made of ABS plastic, which I just learned are like the plastic that you use for like Legos. And they're fully machine painted. They're absolutely gorgeous. You get 5 sets of these: the Sunset, the Hornet, the General, the Midnight Express, and the Mercury. The Mercury is my favorite. It's just really sleek and futuristic looking, like super cool. And each set comes in a metal tin, and these fit exactly perfectly into your Ticket to Ride box. So the deluxe board game train sets, oh my gosh, these are absolutely gorgeous.
Honestly, yeah, I was like, what? They've already made how much? And then you scroll and you're like, yeah, I'll back.
Totally. Instaback, click.
All right, I got an honorable mention as well. I got to tell you about Rolling Plunder. Ruel, you got to like pirates, right?
I do like pirates. You know how much I like pirates, Becca?
I don't know how much. Tell me.
I like pirates so much that Michelle, my wife, made me a pirate hat with a meeple on it.
All right, well, now that I know that I'm talking to a real pirate head, I got to tell you about Rolling Plunder. This is a swashbuckling card and dice adventure game. It's a super cute card game. Basically, the premise is that on your turn, you can either get more crew or you can try and get a better ship by trying to plunder a ship card. And it just looks really fun. You're using battle dice to see if you win or not. And I love pirate stuff, so check it out, Rolling Plunder.
I like pirates. I like pirate games. Obviously, I like pirate hats crafted by my wife. But this one looks really neat. I like the press your luck element to it. And, you know, when you're upgrading your ships and stuff, giving yourself more abilities. I always like those type of mechanisms in games. And this one looks like a lot of fun for 30 minutes or so. Easy to get to the table. And, yeah, The Pirate's Life. It may be for me.
This is by War Games LLC, and because of COVID, they were so kind to just give everyone a print and play version. You can get it at wargamesllc.com for free.
Oh, that's so cool.
On that note, we've done it, Ruel. We've given the gift to all these viewers of Kickstarters they may or may not be interested in, but we definitely are. And if you like this video, please like and definitely subscribe to the channel Good Time Society, where we'll be giving you more videos like this one, videos on role-playing games, and on other how-to-plays and various things related to the tabletop industry. Ruel, tell them where to find you.
Folks, you can find me at Ruel Gaviola or at Gaming with Ruel. You can find me on Twitch, Twitter, Instagram, all the socials.
All right, we'll see you next time. Bye. Can you give me a pirate hat? That...